Hi, this is Focus Biology and I am Barun Prabhat. In this video, I am going to discuss canal system in sponges. Canal system, actually it is characteristic feature of poriferance. Here you can see in this diagram these small pores. These are called ostia. Water enters into the body of sponges through these pores. And here you can see this structure, this larger opening, which is called osculum. And water which enters through ostia exits through this osculum. Canal system is found only in poriferance. Now, types of canal systems and their features. Ascon type, they have flagellated spongocele. Sycon type, they have flagellated radial canals. Leucon type, they have oval flagellated chambers. And Ragon type, they have conical shape and broad base. After this lecture, you can easily remember and distinguish among these four types of canal systems. Now, important components of canal system. Look at this diagram. Here, it is a spongocele. This whole area is indicated by a spongocele, and this area is indicated as outside area. Here you can see small openings. These are called ostium, in plural ostia. And here, if you look at this diagram, then you can find two types of canals. One is this. Here you can see it comes here and it is blind, means it does not open directly into this spongocele. So this is the one canal, and another is this canal. This is called incurrent canal. As you can see here, this is ostium. Water enters into intercurrent canal through this ostium, and this is radial canal. Here this opening is called prosopile, and this radial canal opens into a spongocele through an opening which is called apopile. Here I have indicated incurrent canal. Internally blind. Here this does not open directly into this spongocele, but here it is obstructed, right? Externally opens through ostium. Here you can see incurrent canals communicate with the exterior through this ostium. Radial canal or excurrent canal This one is the radial canal. It has flagellated, this one, cells. These are called flagellated cells. They are closed externally. Here, it is closed externally. But internally, it opens into a spongocele. Prosopile, it connects incurrent canal and radial canal. Here, incurrent canal and excurrent canal or radial canal. Apopile, radial canal, it is opening of radial canal into a spongocele. Now, Ascon type of canal system. This is the simplest type of canal system. Here we first concentrate on this structure. Here these are small openings. These are called ostia, and this opening is called this open space or cavity is called a spongocele. Water enters into this spongocele through this small opening or ostia and exits through a larger opening which is called osculum. This opening is called osculum. Here its main characteristic feature is a spongocele is lined by flagellated cells. These are flagellated cells or flagellated guanocyte cells. So movement of water is ostium to a spongocele to osculum to outside. Osculum is present at the distal free end of the body. Flow of water. Water enters through ostia into a spongocele and through osculum it goes outside. Now, sycon type. Here you can see first in this diagram these are the ostia. Here it is incurrent canal. This is radial canal or excurrent canal. This one is apopiles and this one is prosopiles. Here you can see that body walls folds variously into incurrent canal and radial canals. They have openings called apopiles and prosopiles. Prosopiles connects this incurrent canal to radial canal. Incurrent canal to radial canal, that is IC and RC. IC and RC. Incurrent canal and radial canal. Apopiles connects radial canal and a spongocele, that is RC and S for a spongocele or SC. Here radial canals are flagellated. This one, they are flagellated, flagellated chambers. A spongocele is narrow. You can see here There is no flagellated cells. They are devoid of choanocytes. Body is lined by pinacocytes. But in Granthia, which is a more complex sycon, this incurrent canal becomes irregular and connects to radial canals and forms subdermal space. It will form subdermal spaces. Now, water. Here you can see water moves from outside to incurrent canal. Here, this one through ostium. This is ostia to incurrent canal. This one is incurrent canal. Incurrent canal to radial canal. Here water comes here in current canal to this one radial canal through prosopile. This gate, this opening is called prosopiles, and from radial canals to spongocele. Here this one is a spongocele through this opening, which is called apopiles, and from this spongocele to outside through osculum. This one is osculum. This one is osculum. Then movement of water is like this.